And here he is, the star of our show, direct from the bar.
Mancow.
What? Get a little closer. Get a little closer to the mic.
Is this the mic you want?
Right there. Cheese, move his leg. Move his leg a little bit.
No, I got it. I'm good. You guys. You guys tell me when I'm on. I'll come.
You're on. You're on right now.
It's been a decade. I'm a little bit impaired, but I hope you will bear. You will bear with me. It's been a decade since I've been in here, and I have some issues, but I'm very happy.
It's okay, slow down. It's okay, slow down.
You can call 591, right? 591-ROLL.
591-ROLL. 591-ROLL. 591-ROCK.
Right. Mm-hmm. You can call. And we would love to hear from you. So that would be great. That would be really good.
Eddie Redmayne, everybody!
Thank you. Appreciate it. If he got an Oscar for that shiznit, why can't I? All right? Come on now. Come on. Seriously.
It's insane.
Sometimes it's so big, scary.
Idiot, you're certified.
All right, let's do this. Let's do it. The day. Turn it off. The day was July 6, 1994. I stood at this very spot, and it began. The first song we played was this, because they were coming to Soldier Field. Not Soldier's Field, like I heard the foreigners that want this job the last couple of weeks. And when I say foreigners, I'm talking about that damn Palestinian. No. Hold on. You got to hear this.
I was a butcher caught in a meat. My hands were bloody. I'm dying on my feet. I was a soldier.
Anybody remember this song?
Till I start to shake.
You remember? Al, you
yeah,
were there.
I remember.
Jeez, you were there. Anybody, I mean, you know, the song didn't go on to greatness, but here we go. All right, so there it is. And so what will the first song be? There's a lot of thought into this. And the message, to me, is important. But I want to say something to begin here. And that is, this whole contest thing is not something that I'm fond of. In fact, I don't like it. I don't want you to vote for me. If anything, I would like you to vote for a guy that was a big part of our success, Abe Cannon. The idea was that Abe and I would come in here and do this. And then they said, hey, Abe, why don't you do a week? I remember coming into this studio and seeing the old timers, Dahl, Brandmeier, and the rest, and thinking, God, get out of the way. And even then in 94, it was comeback time for them. Still talking about disco and fishing and Fond du Lac as they broadcast from Hollywood. So for me to stand here and say, hey, yeah, I really would prefer that Abe get it. And that's the truth. Abe, we know that you got work with Howard Stern because you're Jewish, and I'd like to talk about this. The fact is, I love going online and reading the nonsense, the jagoffs, the beeholes. Were you going to say beeholes?
Yeah, you
decided.
Can say beehole.
Okay. So you're a Jewish guy, and that's why Stern hired you, right?
Yeah. So everyone on the message board said I'm either the program director's nephew who's Jewish, yeah, or it's because I'm Jewish.
Of course. And there's a problem.
And not only am I not Jewish, but I'm part German and part Palestinian.
You know, if there's one thing that that the people in Israel love, it's Germans and Palestinians. And wow. How did you feel about your week?
I thought it was good. I mean, are we all?
No, it wasn't very good. This weird. Do you feel weird being here? I feel no competition. I feel, you know, we're buddies. You were a kid. You started on this program, and here we are. I want to say hello to Al Roker Jr. Al, welcome.
Yay!
Sports coming up. What are we going to be talking about?
Much like Neil Patrick Harris, the Blackhawks also took it on the chin yesterday.
Great. And does your wife still sell the the stuff?
Lotions, potions, and marital aids?
Yeah, is that a good side business for her?
She has moved on from that.
Wonderful.
Although, if you do need any at a discount, we still have a bin in the basement.
My scene from Birdman coming up. My scene from Whiplash coming up. 50 Shades still dominates. And this thing paid dividends when I got home. Carrie Ann, have you seen it? Carrie Ann DeYoung is here.
No, it's just not my taste. You know,
what? Your mother writes X-rated fiction.
I know, and I cannot stand like Harlequin novels and all that smushy whatever.
Oh my God, you just gave me a heart attack. Yeah, you see the same old man, Cal.
I
love that too. Is it going to be the same? What's it going to be? And everybody around here has I just love everybody around here. I don't want to say suits, but I love everybody around here. Well, Mancow in 2015 is going to be this. You have no idea. The show is different every day. I've got kids. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's going to be this. It's going to be, it changes every day. I'm not going to talk about the Oscars tomorrow. I'm not going to talk about 50 Shades when it's done. We won't be talking about the Blackhawks. This idea that it's got to be some great new, I don't know. What I really love about the show, the only interest I have in doing this is, there's a lot of streets in this city named after me one way. No, and I don't want to sing the opera, me, 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 me. I want to hear people talk. I don't care about me. I'm bored with me. You think you're bored with me? I'm bored with me. Hmm. I want to, I listen to all of these radio people and they're talking to themselves. Who are they talking to? I want to hear people talk. I want to take your phone calls. 591-ROCK, 591-ROLL. And it's not just some cliche. I hate that too. Hey, we're going to let you pick. We care about you. No, I actually do want you to talk. Okay? Because I know what I think. And I don't want to just sit and listen to my voice. Although it sounds pretty good in these headphones. Mm-hmm. Scrappy is out in the van. Chris Kyle, the American Sniper, his final interview I had, and we're going to have that this week. The bands we have this week, oh man, Night Ranger, Twisted Sister, Bad Company, Quiet Riot, Styx, it's all format specific, and the program director's delighted. I don't care that much.
I'm not sure I am.
We've got a random attractive college girl on the phones. See, he did it again. Say he's got a hot girl answering the phones. He did that before. Yeah, they work for free. And I'll tell you, if you want a big career in radio, this is the place to start. Because radio, I'm telling you, in about 10 years, it's going to be a great business. Your mother writes...
great now.
Yeah, it's the best. There's a big future in it. Forget all you've heard about the internet and all this satellite rigmarole. This is where it's happening. Heavily controlled by the government and loaded down with commercials. Listen, Carrie Ann... your mother writes books that had me sporting wood.
Yeah,
your mother writes erotic fiction, and you didn't like 50 Shades.
No.
I laughed throughout. Have you seen it? Have you seen it? I laughed throughout the movie, but when I got home, the missus, the chosen one, wowie, wow, wow.
Really?
I hosted an Oscar party last night in Naperville. Napervillains in the house. That is the filthiest little suburb. All those women fool around. You know
really?
That.
Yes,
no, no.
They do.
No, am I right?
I heard. Yes, they do.
No, come on.
It's like that strip in Naperville where all the hot white women from Naperville and the fat white women from Aurora who go over to Naperville.
Wait a
they
minute.
They all go to those bars.
We like
and they
Aurora.
All get hammered on drink
was
specials.
Was it boogie nights where you used
go
to?
Over
was
to
it,
the Red Roof Inn and have a good time.
Was it boogie nights where you used to troll for the fat girls? Was that the place?
Oh, boogie nights. Yeah, that was one of the places.
Yes.
Absolutely, yes.
Yes, and I thought about you.
Yeah, right over by the Buco de Beppo off 88.
I thought about you when you, for a lot of really mediocre Italian food cheap, Buco de Beppo. No, it's good. It's great. It's authentic.
You know what a Roker girl is, right?
What?
What is it, Roker? It's a little bit of
well, I don't define Roker girls.
No, but
chubby white girl, usually greasy, wet face.
Oh,
kind of not terribly. Not, no, no. Cute face.
They are usually greasy.
Cute face.
How are we doing on time? I want to make sure I stick on the clock here.
Yeah, we're doing fine.
I 591-ROCK, 591-ROLL. I thought about this. The first song sets the tone. This will be 1 week, I imagine, and 1 week only. A new error here on 97.9 The Loop.